I have a problem. When I woke up this morning, I realized that somehow, over the course of the night, I had completely forgotten all of mathematics, from calculus to geometry to even basic algebra. Now, I could try relearning it all the old-fashioned way, but I'd really rather not get other people involved. I feel like this whole situation would be really awkward and frankly somewhat embarrassing to explain. Instead, I think I'm going to have to try and rebuild all of my mathematics knowledge from scratch. First things first. While I've completely forgotten all mathematical concepts, I do still have some vague recollections of the kind of problems it can solve, and some of the vocabulary associated with them. I have a bunch of apples in boxes, and I feel like it's important to have an idea of how many apples I have. I can take an apple and put it in front of me. Now I can say I have an apple. I can then take another apple and put it in front of me. Now I have an apple, and I have an apple. In fact, I can say that I have, altogether, an apple and an apple. I can take another apple and put it in front of me. Now I have an apple and an apple and an apple. And it's pretty clear at this point that this naming scheme is going to get out of hand fairly quickly. So I should probably come up with some sort of shorthand to use. Let's say that to mean an apple and an apple, I can just say two apples. That feels right for some reason. And then let's say an apple and an apple and an apple is three apples. And an apple and an apple and an apple and an apple is four apples, and so on. Using these shorthand words, I feel like I should say this is counting. And it makes talking about how many apples I have a lot more convenient. I feel like it's worth considering that an apple and an apple, that is, two apples, and another apple, is the same thing as an apple and an apple and an apple, that is, three apples. Also, if I have three apples and I have two apples, that is, an apple and an apple and an apple, and an apple and an apple, then that's the same thing as five apples. Four apples and an apple is also five apples for that matter, and it might be worth pointing out that an apple and four apples is five apples as well. It could be something to think about later. At this point, I think I can say that I have some idea of how many apples I have, but what can I do with this information? Well, let's start by looking at these boxes. Each of these boxes has three apples in it. So by counting up the apples, I can see that I have three apples and three apples and three apples, which is nine apples. This is a lot more convenient to talk about, but I can't help but feel like going straight to nine apples loses some information. After all, I could have nine apples without any boxes being involved. I'm sure that in a lot of cases I won't care about this detail, but I feel like it would be good to have a way to describe what I have here, taking the boxes into account. Come to think of it, I can do the same thing with the boxes of apples that I've been doing with the apples themselves, can't I? If I have a box of three apples, and a box of three apples, I can say that I have two boxes of three apples. And if I have a box of three apples, and a box of three apples, and a box of three apples, I have three boxes of three apples, and so on. Putting all of this together, if I want to preserve the information about the boxes that I have, I can say that I have three boxes of three apples. And if I don't, then I can simplify further and say that I have nine apples. Let's try it again with these other boxes here. I have a box of 2 apples, a box of 3 apples, and a box of 4 apples. That's 2 apples and 3 apples and 4 apples, so I can say that I have 9 apples again. And this means I have 3 boxes of... This situation is a little different than before. Before, all of the boxes were the same. Each of them had 3 apples in it. And so I could say that I had 3 boxes of 3 apples. But this time, the boxes are all different. I do have 3 boxes, but I can't really make counting the apples any simpler than saying I have a box of 2 apples, a box of 3 apples, and a box of 4 apples, without losing information about the boxes. There's something fundamentally different about these boxes, which have different amounts of apples in them. I do feel like it's worth noting that I could take an apple from the box of 4 apples and put it into the box of 2 apples, and then I'd have 3 boxes of 3 apples again. I'm not really sure what to make of this just yet. I might have to think about it more later. Hold on a minute. I just realized that I've been getting a bit ahead of myself. I've been talking about how I have 3 boxes, but I haven't properly thought about counting things other than apples until now. Looking at when I had 3 boxes of 3 apples, even if I ignore the apples completely, I can say a box and a box and a box is 3 boxes. And come to think of it, this seems to work for a lot of things. I can say a frog and a frog and a frog is 3 frogs, or a watering can and a watering can and a watering can is 3 watering cans. There's some fundamental property of threeness that I can think about independently of apples or boxes or frogs or watering cans, in the same way that I have a fundamental understanding of properties like cold or red or explosive. This feels like another thing I should have a word for. Let's say that if I have 3 apples, then 3 is the number of apples that I have, in the same way that I can say that red is the color of those apples. Of course, 2 is a number as well, then, and 4 and 7 and so on. Now that I have this more abstract idea of number, I can think about how it works without having to tie it to specific objects. 2 apples and 3 apples is 5 apples, but this works the same for boxes, frogs, watering cans, and many other things. I can say more generally that 2 and 3 is 5. I know 3 apples and 3 apples and 3 apples is 9 apples, so I can say that 3 and 3 and 3 is 9. And, hold on, it seems like there's a number missing. After all, I know that an apple and 2 apples is 3 apples, but right now I don't have a number to go with an apple. I'm going to have to come up with another word to use here. Let's say 1. So now I can say 1 apple and 2 apples is 3 apples, and so 1 and 2 is 3. Now that things are getting more abstract, I feel like I should start thinking about ways in which this abstraction could break down. This all started with, well, now it's 1 apple and 1 apple being 2 apples. Is there anything which, if I have one of it and another one of it, I don't get 2 of it? I've tried this with apples, frogs, watering cans. How about with clay? If I take 1 clay and 1 clay... This is a little bit tricky. What is 1 clay? one apple is just an apple. But it doesn't really make sense to talk about having a clay. I could have a lump of clay. I suppose I'll consider that for now. If I have one lump of clay and another one lump of clay, well, there's a few different ways it could go. If I just put the lumps of clay in front of me, then I have a lump of clay and a lump of clay, so two lumps of clay. But unlike with the apples, there's nothing stopping me from putting the two lumps of clay together. So I have just one bigger lump of clay. And hang on, I could also end up with three lumps of clay that are smaller, or four lumps of clay that are even smaller. There's something weird going on here, and it's reminding me of the boxes of apples again. I could have a box of three apples and a box of three apples, and say that I have two boxes of three apples, which is six apples. But six apples could also be one box of six apples, or three boxes of two apples. In the same way that I could have two lumps of clay, one big lump of clay, or three small lumps of clay. Lumps of clay act like boxes of apples, with the number of apples in the box acting like the size of the lump of clay. I'm still not really sure how I would count clay, but it seems like as long as I keep them the same size, I might be able to count lumps of clay in the same way that I can count boxes of apples, as long as the boxes have the same number of apples in them. Let's test this out. I've got a container over here that says it has a pound of clay in it, whatever that means. So let's say that this specific lump is 1 pound of clay. If I have 1 pound of clay and 1 pound of clay, and keep them as two separate lumps, then I have 2 pounds of clay. If I combine them, then I have one bigger lump of clay, but since it's not the same size as the 1 pound of clay I put aside, it's still not 1 pound of clay. If I separate it back into two lumps of the same size, I can see it's 2 pounds of clay again. If I treat lumps of clay like boxes of apples, and a pound of clay like one apple, I can say that 2 pounds of clay can be either two lumps of clay, each of which is 1 pound of clay, or one lump of clay that is 2 pounds of clay, in the same way that two apples can either be two boxes of one apple or one box of two apples. This isn't a perfect analogy. I can take my 2 pounds of clay and make it into three evenly sized lumps of something. But I can't put two apples evenly into three boxes. Still, it'll do for now. I can think of some other things that seem to work the same way as clay. I'm not sure how I would count water, for example, but I can count buckets of water and set aside some particular amount of water in the same way that I set aside that pound of clay. There's probably a better way to pick these set-aside amounts, or at least to keep track of them, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. I'd like to stay focused on just the idea of counting. All in all, it seems like I've found two different categories of things. Things that I can count directly, like apples and frogs, and things that I'm not sure how to count directly, but that I can count by grouping them up in a consistent way, like clay or water. It seems like groups of things as a whole, like lumps of clay or boxes of apples, fall into the first category no matter what the thing being grouped up is. There might be more types of things than this, but I can't think of any right now. I'll just have to keep that possibility in mind when I'm counting new things in the future. And with this, I think I've made significant progress in my quest to rebuild mathematics. There's surely still a long way to go, but what I've come up with so far, this concept of number and the process of counting, feels like a solid foundation on which to base further developments.